Hello everyone. In this video, we'll explore how to create powerful HTML data entry forms inside Google Sheets. Data entry forms offer several advantages over direct data entry into spreadsheets. By using forms, you can save time while improving the accuracy and efficiency of your data entry workflow. Let's begin with a working example, and then we'll make modifications to the form to suit your specific requirements. Here's what you need to do. Visit the blog post mentioned in the video description. Scroll down until you find the link to the Google spreadsheet. Click the link and make a copy of the file to your Google Drive. Once the copied Google spreadsheet is fully loaded, you'll notice a new custom menu called My Menu in the menu section. Click on My Menu and select Open Form. When you run this for the first time, it will require your authorization. Simply click OK, then select your email. Next, click Advanced, and then click on the link at the bottom of the pop-up window. Finally, click Allow. After that, go back to My Menu and select Open Form. This will open the data entry form. Simply add some data and submit the form to see how it works. You will be able to view the added data on the sheets once you hit Submit. Now let's see how we can modify this form. This form was created using Google Apps Script. To access the Apps Script project files, go to Extensions and select the Apps Script option. This project contains 5 files. The code.gs file handles the server-side code, responsible for interacting with your Google spreadsheet. The index.html file provides the main structure of the form. The javascript.html file contains the client-side script. It handles form submission and sends the collected data to the server for processing. The form.html file contains the specific HTML code that makes up the form itself. The css.html file allows you to link external CSS files for styling, and you can also include your own custom CSS styles directly within that file. The pop-up window containing this form is known as a modal dialog. Now, let's explore how we can modify the title of this form. You can locate the pertinent code section within the Open Form function of the code.gs file. Make the necessary changes to the name, then relaunch the form to see the updates. Now let's learn how to modify form fields. For example, we'll change the product description field to product details. These interface changes are made within the form.html file. The product description field is a text input field, consisting of 2 main elements, the label and the input field itself. Notice how the same string used for the ID and name attributes within the input field is also used in the label tag. It's essential to maintain this consistency when editing. The name attribute is crucial for later retrieval of the data submitted from the form. Let's change the label to product details and update the ID, name, and for attributes with the same string. Next, open the code.gs file and update the corresponding field name within the process form function. Finally, while not strictly necessary for form functionality, it's good practice to update the relevant column heading in your connected Google spreadsheet to maintain consistency. Let's reopen the form again and submit some test data to see if it still works. You can see that the form is working fine. Let's create a new text input field next to the product details field. You can achieve this easily by duplicating and modifying an existing text input field. Let's name this field Brand. Then update the label and other attributes as previously explained. After that, you'll need to add this new field to the process form function. We'll also add a new column next to the product details column to store data from our new field. Let's open the form and input some sample data to check if it's functioning properly. Now, let's add a new item to the drop-down list. You can do this easily by duplicating an option tag. The value attribute contains the data that is sent to the database once the option is selected. The text in black represents what the user sees in the drop-down list. Make sure to update both texts accordingly. Let's verify the drop-down list to ensure our new item has been added. Let's explore how to add another radio button to the product condition field. To achieve that, start by duplicating this div tag in the radio button field. In this field, the name attribute remains the same for all radio buttons to ensure they function as a group. However, each radio button requires a unique ID. The value attribute specifies the data sent to the database upon selection. Make sure to update these attributes along with the corresponding labels. Let's check the form once again and submit some data to see how it works. The updated form fields are functioning as expected. You can resize the form using the set width and set height methods in the open form function in the code.js file. In this code, we utilize the Bootstrap CSS framework to style our form. If you require additional form elements, refer to the Bootstrap documentation. You can simply copy these code snippets to the corresponding form elements and integrate them into your project. Thank you for watching.